Welcome back to Easy Duplicate Finder. Today's tutorial, Finding Duplicate Songs. I'm Mike Summers, Product Manager for Easy Duplicate Finder. All set? Great. Let's begin. Double-click on the Easy Duplicate Finder icon. The program launches, and you are greeted with our welcome screen. You'll also find helpful tech tips at the beginning of the program. Let's first go to the Settings menu. Click on the Settings button. You'll notice that we've added a new feature called Compare Music Tags. Go ahead and select this. Then, select the Music Tags tab. Take a moment and view the options on this screen. You can use any of these criteria by which to search for duplicate songs. You can search by the song title, by the artist, by the genre, etc. But go ahead and select your choices and click on OK. Step 2 is to choose the location where to focus our search. I'll select my external hard drive and click on Add to include to scan. For music files, search filters are automatically set, which means Easy Duplicate Finder is configured and ready to go. Simply click on the Start button. Search times depend greatly on a number of factors, number of songs, search criteria, etc. This may take several minutes to several hours to complete. When the scan completes, a dialog box shows you the number of total files scanned, the number of original files, as well as the number of duplicates of those files. Go ahead and click on the Go Fix Them button, and we'll look at the details of the songs. A large number of duplicate songs has been detected. To gain even further details, right-click in the column header area to select additional details. While in the results area, you can manually choose which songs to keep and which to rename, move, or delete. Simply click the line of any song that you'd like to remove, rename, or delete. A much faster and easier method is to use the Auto Select feature, which can be accessed by right-clicking in the Results area or simply by clicking on the Auto Select button. From the Auto Select list, I've decided to keep all the songs with the highest bit rates. With those selected, I just need to decide what to do with all these duplicates. I might choose to simply rename them. Easy Duplicate Finder makes it easy by adding a pre or post fix to each duplicate file. Or I can move them all to a different folder or to a different drive entirely. For anyone nervous about permanently deleting any file, this is usually the best choice. The delete option will remove the duplicates from your computer completely. You can either send them to the recycle bin or you can remove them permanently. But for this tutorial, I've decided to keep all the duplicates and move them instead to a separate folder. With all the duplicates selected, I'll now click on the Move to Folder button. I've decided to create a new folder on the external hard drive and move all my duplicates there. By enabling Preserve Folder Structure, all of the original file paths will be created in the new folder on the external hard drive. Depending on a number of factors, the time it takes to move your files will vary. The operation completes after all of the duplicate songs have been moved to their new location. All songs affected are now crossed out and marked in red. To prove that all the duplicate songs are now resolved, let's rerun the exact scan that we started with. I'll scan the entire disk, but I'll exclude the folder we just created and moved all the duplicate files to. If we're right, we shouldn't find any new duplicates. Great! No duplicates found. That's just what we want to see. All of the duplicate songs have been resolved. And that concludes this tutorial on finding and resolving duplicate songs. This has been Mike Summers, your host. Thank you for watching and listening.